G'day guys, back again. This time I thought we could have a look at the crazy design of the Frog Hopper MK2. And I just like this little design. Obviously it's a little bit of a mix-up between a snow speeder and part of an X-Wing. It's very odd looking. And also it's in 135 scale, which is the scale I like the most. It's just one of those kits again that you won't see too many of them in a model competition or show, so I kind of like putting things in that there aren't 10 of in a show, so I just thought I'd show you guys this one. Obviously you can see the details down there of who made it, and I picked this one up a little while ago, and I think there might be a couple of different versions of this kit, so let's have a look at the kit. Got all the parts laid out, and there's a few parts. I wouldn't say there's heaps, but there's a fair few parts for just a small type of resin, even so maybe garage kit. I picked up the option with the actual landing gear. See, it had a couple of different options of what you could pick up. And obviously you've got the engines there, your canopy, your main body, your wings, some little console parts for inside the cockpit. Here are the lights here, but I'll just give you a quick closer look at the parts. So here's the main body of the kit. I really admire people just kit bash a kit, then obviously put it all together, and then obviously offer it to the public. And I also like the fact that this one is very well detailed, as you can see. And often sometimes with these sort of limited version kits, they can be a little bit, not in a mean way, I don't mean this in a mean way, but they can be a little bit dodgy, but obviously that's not because a large company with a lot of money hasn't made it. But this kit itself has been done very well. All the little panel lines have been done nicely. As you can see there, you might notice that little bit there looks a little bit familiar to some degree, reminds me of an X-Wing. And obviously it's been a bit of a kit bash, but yeah, in fairness, Star Wars also did kit bash their kits from Tamiya parts and other people's parts, so I don't think there's really anything wrong with that. Now I've got here my trusty little Breagle 135 scale pilot figure. I have got the Breagle as well, hope I'm pronouncing that right. And this figure's a cracker of a little figure. And so is that kit. It's massive and the casting on it's unbelievable. And that's also in 135 scale, which I will do a video of later. But I just thought I'd put him in the little cockpit here to show you the size. And he's roughly pretty close to your standard 135 scale figure. So he's not one of those really tiny ones, and he's not a large 54mm or larger figure. So I just thought I'd put him in there for you, just so you could see the size of him. So here he is here, just sitting in the back seat. And he fits in there very nicely. I've got a little bit of blue tack in holding him in because he's sort of sliding around a little bit. But as you can see there, there's plenty of room for a 135 scale figure if you're thinking about modding your own figures. And I'll just whack him in the front seat for you. As you can see, I couldn't get him to sit all the way down because his arms are sort of interfering with the side control panels. So he's actually sitting a bit higher, but I just thought I'd show you his leg room and how much room he's got in there. So he's definitely got enough room to play in there. And as you can see, he's sitting a lot higher just because I haven't got him sitting all the way down due to his arms. You also get these two little parts here that fit inside the control panels for the front and back. So that sort of clears up that sort of empty spaces. And what I would say is, wow, I actually just literally pulled this out of the box to do this video for you guys, and I hadn't actually put any parts together, so I just actually slapped these two pieces of resin in here, and they just really just fit it into place straight away. That looks pretty awesome. Look at that, with him sitting in there like that. God damn. I said god damn. Again, as I said before, in the front seat, my little Breagle pilot figure doesn't want to sit in there properly because he's used to his rather large and beautiful mech, and this is just a little tiny one, so he's not too happy sitting in there. But as you can see, if you took out the legs, there's plenty of room for him to sit down there. Then obviously the next part you get is this lovely canopy. It's done really well. Obviously you can take the resin out for where the windows are, or you've got the option to take them out, And they give you some clear sheet there if you want to add the windows, which is nice. Or if you don't, which I don't know why you wouldn't, you could always just paint this a gloss back black or something like that. But given that the interior is there, I think you'd be crazy to do that. And this will just sit on the top like so, like that, which again would look really nice painted up with a clear glass in there, seeing the pilots. And again, I've got a bit of a casting block at the back here, which is not letting that sit down flush on that. I'll just show you a close-up of the wings and the engines. The detail on these is fantastic. Underneath as well, you also get the little open areas for your little landing gear. So there's not really a lot of mucking around there. I'll just test fit something like that in there. Come on, this is a limited little garage kit, if you want to call it that. And just look how that fits in there so easily. Hopefully my hands won't take all the focus there, but look at this little fella. What a great little kit. Here's a landing gear. And I like how they've given you a different piece for the front part and the two for the back. I like how they're different rather than all being the same. And here are the four engine pieces. I like how they've mixed them up a bit, so they've got two different from the other two. Here are the front little lights here. And if you wanted to, you could obviously drill those out and add your own type of real lighting to those. Here are the rest of the parts. As you can see, it's all nicely detailed. I've got a little bit of warping in my little laser gun there, but that's a very, very thin piece of resin there, so that's to be expected. Just to put that in a bit of warm water and straighten up, it's not really going to be a problem. Or if you really wanted to, you could add your own little piping to that if you wanted to strengthen it up a bit so it doesn't snap off. I'll just show you the overall measurement of this kit. It's 7.5 and by 7.75 inches. I didn't mention it before, but you actually do get a nice set of instructions that go with the kit. And they take you through by actual photographs, which is a nice way of doing it if you're a small little company or person doing it on your own. So there you have it, guys, a little Frog Hopper Mark II. I love how it's 135 SCAR. I love how you can already pick up figures that will basically just sit in the cockpit. It's a really nice kit. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you later.